Good afternoon, everybody. This is Cher, Grin and Grandma. And we are in Zephyrs, Zephyr apostrophe S, in Abingdon, Virginia. And we are in our booth there. These are, of course, ours. This is the outside or the side of one of our booths. And this is a shop that sells a lot of smalls. So it seems like we always have to replenish when we come in here. We still had some Christmas in here and we took it out. Hopefully we got it all. This is an old butter churn, but we don't have the handle on it, so we only have $30 on it. And we have a variety of different glasses and everything. You've seen this before, I'm sure. Yes, you have. I've shown it to you before. And I truly don't know what it is. We got it from a house that had world travelers living. Well, let me rephrase that. The house it came from did belong to world travelers, and they had a lot of really interesting pieces, but none of them were tagged as to where they actually originated. So that's one. And I think it might be Asian, could be Indian, shoot, I don't know. But anyway, it's $125, it's very, very heavy. And it does hold fruit, or you could put flowers in it. Well, put anything you want to in it, it's that large. And this is toward the back. That's probably about a 60s sewing kit, and there were some items that were still left in it, and I took just a few out. Most of them are still in there. This carriage is, I'm thinking, Dutch, but it's from the 1800s. Wouldn't that look cute in a cabin? Of course, we've mixed some old and with the new. Or I should say, not new, but I should say decorative in with the old. We've got a lineup of beer and Coke bottles up there. And this is one more reason for me to take a look at everything when I'm filming, because I didn't price this. But this is another paperweight. Actually, it was a, oh doggone it, it was an award. But there's no plaque on it or anything, but I think it makes a wonderful paperweight. It's mouth blown. Still has the box, of course. The glass actually is loose from the base, so I have to put that on the label so everybody will know to not drop it. Murano chicken. This is Longaberger. These four bowls or longer burger. If you like spaghetti, hey, this is for you. Some more canisters. I sold something similar to this without the angels. It was a pear. On eBay right before Christmas. They do still take school pictures, don't they? These colanders always seem to sell, but for some reason that one isn't. Doesn't look like Pooh Bear. I guess they can't call it Pooh Bear. And another Wilton cake tin. As I said, lots of smalls is what we always keep in here. This shelf doesn't have anything in it because I didn't hang it correctly. Not funny. Don't want it to fall down and break something that's valuable. Because between you and me, that shelf really isn't. This is a Lear, handmade, right here in Appalachia somewhere. Art glass shaped like a kind of like a sconce. And this is another piece from that estate that I told you about earlier, where the people were world travelers. This, I know, is a flower pot I'd put real flowers in this because it does have a frog, but isn't this cool? The phoenix motif. I believe this is Japanese. Hi, how are you?
Doing well, yourself?
Good. Just talking to myself back here.
I hear you.
And these figures here are collectible. They're Meadowbank cottages. But I don't think a whole lot of people know about them, so they haven't given them a real serious look. And again, this table. I don't understand why it's still here. Showed this to you the last time I was here. And here's Hoss. A huge, huge plush. And it has the Colts logo on the side. This is a potato bin. Some people call them or use them as trash bins. And this, I actually was going to take this home with me. It's a refilling dog bowl. You put a, well, here's a picture right inside here. You put a 2-liter bottle of water right here in this container, and you have water for the rest of the day, or for most of the day anyway, for your animals. What have we got on that? $35. And this huge sponge and coral piece, 13 pounds. And it is big. I'm going to put my, I've got stuff in my other hand, so I can't handle things for both of you. But I'm going to put my, or both of the things that I'm holding. Gee, getting tired. I stutter when I'm tired. But anyway, you can see how large it is by my cleaning bottle here. And that's it for our booths here in Zephyrs, Abingdon, Tennessee. Thanks again for making the trip here with me and for watching. And if you like this type of video, please subscribe, like, comment. I'd appreciate it. Thanks again and God bless. Bye-bye. Hi again. This time we are, of course, we're still in Abingdon, Virginia. And we are in the antique barn on Main Street. And these are our two downstairs booths. We brought Alice in from one of the other shops. She had graced their shelves long enough. She's got Rabbit with her. And we also brought over Grandma and Grandpa. Or George. And a lady other than Mrs. George. He looks like George to me. Trust me, he was not modeled after them or him. I think these were modeled in the 70s. When was he in office? Shoot, I can't remember. That's how old I'm getting. But I'm hoping that this doesn't pick up on the music in the background. I told my husband over at Zephyrs that that music is so old, I don't think there are any copyrights on it, so. Okay. Anyway, it's been a while since I've been here, too. Actually, I guess it's been a while since I've been to any of these shops, so it's a good thing that I finally decided to get out and visit them, huh? Okay, this is our other... These booths are attached. I guess you probably figured that one out. The desk that we brought in the same time that we brought this basset dresser and mirror in has sold, but this is still here. We do have this little chest. And it's $85. And I was just told that, ooh, we need some more stuff there. That's not what I was told. I was just told that our rent has gone up here too, but... not as much as the other shops, so we're still okay here. Rent is still reasonable. Went up 11%. And yes, we still have Christmas. What a cute little picture.
I just notice what the little boy is doing. And his dog is watching. And, oh, we've got this little bitty. I caught an ice cream chair, but that's not what this one is. It's not tall enough. And these are our downstairs booths. We obviously didn't bring in enough stuff to fill these booths. Fill these shelves, I mean. And let's go upstairs and take a look. Okay, now we are in our single booth upstairs in the barn. And evidently these two have been here for a while. I remember bringing them in before Christmas. This, of course, is hanging sideways, but this is a little primitive handmade rocking chair that probably, whoops, almost fell. Probably some grandpa made for his lucky grandchild. This is another shop that we generally sell a lot of smalls in, and it shows by the looks of all these empty shelves. There's a scene from our window up here. And this, everyone, is Virginia. We're part of it. I think this is gorgeous, and we don't have a big price on it, but maybe the problem is that the piece itself is so large. It's $12. Mikasa. And it is heavy. We've had that for quite a while. If any of you want anything that you see here, especially some of these items like this Mikasa piece, I will make a very good deal for you. _ very. Got two curio cabinets that my husband brought in. I think it was last week. This blue fiber chair is $75. Our chairs don't last very long here. And this blue curio cabinet is only $119. And every time I'm up here, I always, for some reason, want to show you this duck art again. Actually, it's feather art, it's not duck art. Let me stand back so you can see. It's made in Mexico. It's all handcrafted. Look at the workmanship on this wood. And now, let's focus in on one of the ducks. Those are feathers. I think it's just gorgeous. What an art form. Each of these ducks is made of feathers. And I've got this marked down. $85. Maybe that's too much. I don't know. Maybe I'm one of one who likes it. Or one of two, because I'm sure the artist did. And this is scratch art. You know, when you were in school and you had to take a crayon and you colored over and over many layers of crayon on the same page, and then you took a pencil or something sharp and carved a picture into the all that those layers of crayon. Well, that was scratch art. And that's it for up here. And I thank you again. And please, I'm going to remind you once more, if you like this type of video, please like, subscribe, and comment. Love to hear what you say. Thanks again. Really do appreciate you.